We're one of the best boxing and MMA gyms in Los Angeles, the Fortune Gym. You should come check it out. Here's the number, 323-845-4755. Vito Gasparian, you're a fighter, you're one of the trainers. Justin Fortune, former heavyweight fighter. So first of all, the big news of the day, 50 Cent leaving Floyd to join Manny Pacquiao, maybe promote his fight.
That wouldn't happen, man. I just read a little bit about it, like you just told me about the news, I didn't read about it, so I just read it.
Not to promote it, to go on board, because Bob just promoted.
Right, but to help, like to, what do you say, going from Floyd to Manny?
Well, I mean, let me tell you something, you think like 50 Cent is good enough to help Bob Arum, one of the greatest promoters ever, to promote the fight? That's not gonna happen. I mean, Bob Arum is top two promoters, Don King, Bob Arum, Don King is gone, almost gone. Top Arum is top rank is already out there, and Golden Boy is making his moves to be on the top. Maybe he's one of the top. Maybe he's better than Bob Arum right now. But Bob Arum is the best promoter out there.
I mean, okay, but when I walked up here today, I said, "Hey, 50 Cent might be leaving Floyd and joining the Manny side." You guys were shocked, surprised. You didn't expect it.
No, I didn't expect Floyd to leave 50 Cent to leave Floyd so quick, but then.
That won't happen.
Maybe 2 months.
Maybe they split up, but I mean I don't think like he would do such thing. I mean they're friends. I don't like how much friendship means for them, but at the end of the day, I mean you would never do that to even your ex friend.
Okay, let me ask you, Justin. You worked with Manny Pacquiao for 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
Were you around for the first Marquez fight way back when?
Yeah, I was back. First time he came here was Pereira. Yeah. Then he's just knocked out all of, you know, Golden Boys. Yeah, I was there from the start.
Okay, so what do you think about him fighting Juan Manuel Marquez December 8th for the fourth time?
Who cares? What are you going to do? Screw Marquez likes it because it's a big payday for Marquez. You know what I mean? But, I mean, really? The hardcore fans, who gives a shit? What are you going to fuck Marquez again?
So, Vito, who would be a good matchup for Manny that you would be interested in seeing right now?
Besides Mayweather?
Yeah.
Garcia in the 47s out there are good.
Danny Garcia?
Yeah.
You don't like
him? Alvarado. There's a lot of guys, a lot of 47s out there. That are worth.
Well, I mean, those are for 40 pounders, and I think still like on that high level, still like I don't think like they're good enough for it.
What about Robert Guerrero or Devin Alexander?
No, Alexander.
And Alexander lost to Bradley, like couldn't handle Bradley's speed.
Sergio Martinez?
Well, Sergio Martinez is too big. That would be interesting, but he's too big.
Cotto again?
I'd give Cotto another shot. He's sort of 40s. God, listen, I'd rather watch a Cotto fight, like the last Cotto that fought Mayweather. He beats Manny. I'd rather watch Cotto again than friggin' Mike.
I don't even know who to watch anymore. Like, when it comes to Pacquiao, Pacquiao fighting somebody, yeah, exactly. Canelo. Would that fight happen? That fight would never happen.
Never.
So basically, there are top fighters, they're not fighting each other. What is this, like Canelo fighting like Josecito Lopez?
That's a good fight, actually.
Yeah.
It's a very good fight, man.
It's such a good fight.
What are you talking about? It's a good fight. Come on, you've been in boxing. What's a good fight? Josecito Lopez versus him? Like, the guy, like, in 2-3 months...
He earned it, though. He moved
up to weight divisions, 14 pounds. You gotta be kidding me.
Well, he walks around much heavier than he... You know that, but...
Yeah, he made 140...
Okay, was he supposed to beat Victor Ortiz? No, but he did. And he earned
how
it, did so.
He earned it. He earned a payday. $200,000?
Probably.
Earned that? Okay, one more thing. Like, he earned that to fight 154. He earned that to fight, like, top 147 pounders, not 154. I mean, I'm happy for him that he's gonna get paid like $200,000. Maybe he would never get paid that much money.
$215.
It's not even that good of a money, but I mean, like, it's still something.
That sucks.
Yeah, $2 million. Canelo gets paid $2 million. I read somewhere like he still gets paid like $215,000. I mean, it's still something, but I mean, like, they made him jump to weight divisions. What do you think is gonna be a competitive fight? What's your opinion?
I think it's going to be competitive because Josecito comes forward.
Four rounds. If Josecito comes forward, it's going to be less than 2 rounds.
Hey, what are we betting here? Let's have a bet going.
Let's have a bet. You owe me push-ups. About 1,000 push-ups. Where are my push-ups? You're a typical Jewish guy, my friend. You lose and you don't pay.
Where's the push-ups?
I'll do them.
Okay.
I'll be here Monday morning, back from Vegas.
It's a shame you put fucking Lopez and Canelo on the same night as those guys.
No, the other guys.
Canelo deserves his own fucking life.
Well, Canelo was there first, and then the other fight came along. But it's good for boxing to have two big events in one night.
It just it's not that big of a event.
It's not good for maybe for fans, but it's good for the sport. It's a lot of exposure on two different networks.
Hey, whenever you see people are talking about Chavez and Martinez.
What's Canelo? What show? What channel is that on?
Showtime. But it's a sick undercard. You have a very good fight.
Undercard, yeah. Maidana fighting Soto.
Maidana Soto Caraz.
That's a good fight. Gonzalez fighting Ponce de Leon.
That's a very good fight.
That's a good fight. And one more.
Leo Santa Cruz is a very good fighter too, and he has a good fight.
Yeah, he's fighting.
Eric Morrell, right?
Eric Morrell. Imagine Eric Morrell getting paid $30,000 only, man. And they have like, I think like $100,000 bonus, right?
Best knockout.
For anybody on that card,
a Canelo's card.
I mean, basically, Canelo gonna get that.
You think so?
It's gonna be $2,100,000.
I think someone else gets it.
Well, I think Maidana gets it.
You think Maidana gonna beat Soto Caraz?
I think so.
I said he can't beat him, but I mean, on the cuts. If it goes to the fight, I highly doubt who's gonna win that fight. That Maidana gonna win that fight. I have still like Soto Caraz. Give him a credit. He's a real welterweight.
Why did Mayweather and Cent break up?
Someone sent me a message that 50 Cent was on the radio to say that he and Floyd got in a fist fight over $10,000 at the Palms Hotel. I don't know if that's true. I have to look into it, but that's one reason.
There will be
Mayweather and 50 Cent got in a fist fight.
That's what someone
50
said.
50 Cent comes off better, worse there. Mayweather will fucking kill it. Mayweather can fight.
It's a street fight. You never know.
Street fight my ass.
And Mayweather has a lot of bodyguards.
One guy can punch, one guy can't punch. Jeff Fennett was knocking out motherfuckers twice as big as him because he can punch. Simple as that.
Did you see that video? I think it was a guy from Russia or Armenia. He knocks out like six people on the street. Some guy, was Armenian guy? Did you see that?
No, it's Armenian guy.
He knocked out six people in a street fight?
Street fight. Yeah.
Street fight, a boxer, and they kept coming at him just and he knocks one after the other. Like
Armenians would do that to you.
That's when someone knows how to punch. Don't
get on a red Armenian's way. Red Armenian. Might be somebody else. But. So, anyways, there are the things.
Okay. My last question: Sergio Martinez or Chavez Jr.? Who wins that?
I said that again, Martinez. If decision goes to Chavez Jr., it means Martinez got robbed. Like I said, like I give Chavez Jr. more chances right now. I was saying like a year ago, I was saying like Sergio Martinez would destroy him. Now I give Chavez like slightly chance to win. But like it's like 85-90% like Martinez is gonna beat him.
I was reading that Suleiman's having a bitch about not being able to pick the couldn't pick the judges.
I heard about that.
He's upset at the Nevada Commission.
Yeah, especially.
Why, so he didn't want fucking so he could guarantee Chavez a win.
Especially after watching Andy Lee fight, Martinez is really good on his legs. It's not gonna be in front of him like Andy Lee was.
He's fine now.
So and it's gonna be 20-20 ring. It's not gonna be that small. Like Luke DiBella said, he's gonna be like doing all the stuff, like measuring the ring. And gloves are gonna be good and everything is gonna be fine and Martinez is gonna win the fight. Come on.
I agree with you on that one. We agree that Sergio beats Chavez Jr. for usagecoin.com. I'm Ali Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. Kind of check the balance.